What's up, guys? Geeks of the West here. How are y'all doing? Welcome to Geek Talk. We all love scary games, don't you? I sure do. I freaking love scary games. There's nothing like having your adrenaline rush throughout an entire gaming experience. It's a good time. You feel vulnerable. You face scary or superior enemies. I am here to share with you my top 5 favorite scary games. Number 5, Resident Evil 4.
It was right before I was to take on my duties of protecting the president's daughter that she was abducted. Who would have thought that my first job would have been a rescue mission?
Resident Evil 4 has a chilling atmosphere and adrenaline-inducing music. It perfectly combines the elements of action and horror. Enemies are superior in strength compared to you. And treading away from traditional Resident Evil installments, Resident Evil 4's enemies have the ability to work together in order to accomplish goals. Resident Evil 4 was one of my most favorite games to play when growing up. Number 4, Resistance: Fall of Man. PlayStation 3 exclusive Resistance Fall of Man sends you directly into a catastrophic war taking place in an alternate World War II era Western Europe. You are put in the shoes of an American sergeant named Nathan Hale, and you're part of a last-ditch effort to save the United Kingdom from certain destruction against a species known as the Chimera. While this seems like another war game where you have teammates to back you up every step of the way, the pace quickly changes as you come across an abandoned military British base, and you have no choice but to fight the superior and technologically advanced species from a seemingly unknown origin.
Millions are dead, but hundreds of millions more.
Number 3, Doom 3. Doom 3, originally released in 2004, was met with a re-release with polished graphics and expansion packs included in 2012. This game has beautiful graphics no matter which version you play. However, Doom 3 is slightly more scary than Doom 3 BFG Edition, as you're forced to choose between wielding your flashlight that you'll need in hard-to-see environments, or a weapon that you're all gonna also need against the frightening forces of hell. Doom 3 also does a wonderful job at mixing elements of action and horror. You don't have regenerating health, and some enemies are bullet sponges. Number 2, Stalker: Shadow of Chernobyl. Stalker: Shadow of Chernobyl, a PC exclusive made by the now defunct THQ, places you in the shoes of an illegal artifact scavenger explorer in an alternate Cold War era setting where a second nuclear accident happens in the near future at the Chernobyl nuclear power plant exclusion zone, causing an alteration in the area around it. This game is a non-linear first-person shooter with role-playing elements implemented. If you're a fan of Fallout or Metro Last Light, you will probably find this game enjoyable. If you like first-person shooters or role-playing games, this would be an enjoyable game for you as well. You scavenge through an open world overrun by thieves, warlords, wild animals, and mutated radioactive monsters. This game is scary as you feel extremely vulnerable in an environment that seemingly wants to kill you. Humans, animals, and mutated monsters are out to get you with the radioactive environment. And if you're not careful, you'll die of radiation sickness. Not to mention, you get the feeling of dread and loneliness when playing this game. The quest pacing is excellent as you have a variety of different enemies to face with excellent pacing. Now, I just spent a lot of time with Stalker Shadow of Chernobyl. These are all great games, and I don't favor any of them over the other. However, you're probably wondering what's the last game I'm going to include on this list. Before I finish, I'd like to take the time to explain that links to buy these wonderful games are in the description box below. Now for number one, this game does a great job with limiting what weapons you can choose to use, while at the same time giving you an equal opportunity to combat your enemy. This game is like a crime drama, detective, police, procedural, supernatural, suspenseful horror game all in one. It's so scary, it's good. It is condemned to Bloodshot. You play as a Special Forces agent, Ethan Thomas. This game takes place 1 year directly after Condemned Criminal Origins, and I won't spoil too much in case you haven't played the first one.
I've seen plenty of bad things in this city. Nothing like this, though.
Her decapitated body was found earlier today at the museum.
I can't tell the difference.
This game will make you descend into chaos. It's good, it's scary. I recommend this to fans of Outlast and Fear.
My name is Ethan Thomas. I work for the Serial Crimes Unit. And the blood on my hands ain't never washing off.
On that note, I recommend all of these games to you. If you're gonna play Condemned 2, or you've played Condemned 2, I'm gonna recommend a movie to you guys. This movie is a supernatural crime thriller. It's really good in my honest opinion, highly underrated. Critics liked the movie, but said it didn't add anything new to the genre. I highly disagree as it takes a different perspective on the genre. This movie is called Deliver Us From Evil.
But nothing that can't be explained by human nature.
Then you haven't seen true evil.
Hi, Daddy. I'm going to sleep now. First, I want to tell you that I love you, and I miss you.
Be safe tonight.
It reminds me so much of Condemned 2 Bloodshot in terms of setting and loosely on story.
Hey, Sergeant Sachi, right?
What's the damage here?
Weirdest thing, the whole zoo lost power.
The story follows a veteran member of a South Bronx precinct played by Eric Bana, accompanied by his partner played by Joel McHale, as they take on a series of bizarre calls during a very stormy New York night. The bizarre calls eventually leads the detective to team up with a renegade priest played by Edgar Ramirez. I won't give away too much, however, if you're a fan of older music like The Doors or thrillers with moons like The Prisoners, Untraceable, or you like the movies The Exorcist, The Exorcism of Emily Rose, Sinister, or you like the games Heavy Rain and Condemned 2 Bloodshot, this movie is a movie you should watch. Even if you only said yes to one of those that I listed, you should still watch this movie. Even if you said no to all of those, you should still watch this movie. Thank you for watching Geek Talk Countdown. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. I have so many more videos of different varieties that cater to gaming, tech, and media in general. This is Geeks of the West, signing out.
Your investigation puts you and your family in danger.
I heard scratching noises under the floor in her room.
Scratching noises?
It makes you a target for the demonic.
Mommy.
Athena!
We gotta stop this.